As the Cabinet Secretary for National Treasury, I'm here for two reasons. One, to have a meeting with the committee, National Assembly Committee, on delegated legislation. We had an opportunity to critical regulation, one on the equalization fund, which has stalled as a result of a court decision that nullified the previous guideline. And we have been able to go through. We've had series of stakeholder engagement that involved Council of Governors, that initially actually went to court, that led to the subsequent nullification of the previous policy. So we've had very good engagement, both at the national level, at the county level, through engagement with the various counties. We constituted an interagency team that involved county government, national government, commissions, CRA, control of budgets, Council of Governors, various departments of government. And through this, we were able to come to an understanding of a hybrid system that all of us are going to have a stake in, as far as planning and budgeting and identification of the various projects, because the equalization fund places responsibility on implementation on both the national government and the county government, because some of the functions belong to the county government, like health and water, but it also places responsibility on areas of roads, education, which is basically a national government function. 30 billion that have been lying idle since the prolongation of the current constitution. As you know, constitution equalization fund is 0.5% of audited revenue every year. And so over time it's been accumulation, and the disbursement has been poorly done because of those the poor decision. Number two, we were also able to go through regulations that institutionalizes the project implementation management. Over time, we've realized that the way projects are conceptualized and taken through the process of the project cycle, including pre-feasibility study, feasibility study, actual appraisal, budgeting, and as well as issues monitoring and evaluation, has not been up to date. We've seen cases of a number of stalled projects because of poor planning. We've seen cases of projects that they, at the end of the project exercise, the cost could actually triple on what was actually initially planned.